Today, we have a problem. The problem is we have two friends. Actually, having two friends is not a problem, yeah? What I mean is the problem is about our two friends. So the first friend, he's spiky, yeah? And the other friend, she's curly, yeah? So Spiky thinks that this multiply, yeah? I'll write multiply like that, yeah? Spiky was trying to do this, yeah? And Curly, she was also trying to do the same thing, right? And Spiky got this. And Curly got this. Tell your friend, what did they do?
Basically, in an inquiry-based learning, students are given a problem to inquire into. And hopefully, they work with their friends, and with the help of a teacher, they will get to the eventual outcome for the lesson.
So in the first part, you can see there are several calculations you're asked to do. Can you use your calculator to work out the four calculations? As you work with the calculations, please do not be quiet, yeah? It's not for you to just do the worksheet, yeah? It's for you to talk with your friends. So as you do it, talk to your friends. In particular, tell your friends why it makes sense, why it doesn't make sense, if there's a pattern.
Scientific calculators are used to make lesson studies easier and more convenient. It reduces the problem that we have for counting complex and large numbers. It also helps us count faster and save a lot of time. From the time that we save, we can learn more things and solve more problems. We can get the results or product number in several forms. Example, in standard form, in prime factor form, etc. Using a scientific calculator also reduces the chance of us miscounting. This makes us more confident in our answers. This can also help us be more active, and the class will be livelier.
Melalui penggunaan kalkulator saintifik, kita tidak harus menghitungnya secara manual, sehingga hal ini membantu kita dalam mengenali pola dengan lebih cepat dan akurat. Selain itu, kalkulator saintifik juga memiliki fitur grafik yang dapat mendukung pembelajaran dan pemahaman saya. Misalnya nih, tadi ada fungsi yang angkanya cukup rumit. Nah, dengan adanya kalkulator saintifik, kita hanya perlu memasukkan fungsi tersebut ke dalam kalkulator dan kemudian grafiknya akan muncul di HP kita melalui QR code. Jadi kita tidak perlu menghitungnya secara manual untuk mengenali pola dari fungsi tersebut.
The role of scientific calculator in inquiry-based learning, I think the first one would be when students are investigating. During investigation in mathematics, very often students have to do repetitive calculation. And if we do this by hand, either it is just not humanly possible or it is just time consuming and at the very least, boring.
By doing exploration tasks in groups, it actually helps me understand a lot of the concept and material more deeply. Because the help of other friends, we could discuss it together. And even if I stumble upon difficulties, I could easily ask my friends inside that group so we can discuss it thoroughly. Maybe there's a part of the problem that I don't know how to solve. Maybe there's a part of the problem that I don't really understand. We could discuss it thoroughly together with my friends. And not only that, actually working in groups saves time. We can get the job done even quicker and more efficiently, of course. So basically, doing it in groups means completing each other's ideas and concepts.
In inquiry-based learning, very often, students do some kind of exploration semi-independently, often in collaborative setting. There are several benefits to this. I think the obvious one is the opportunity to learn how to collaborate, how to work with other people, how to make use of a friend's idea and synthesize it with their own. Or sometimes synthesizing two friends' ideas to come up with something that is insightful or maybe even novel. Other than collaboration, I think another benefit students reap from such a way of learning is to be independent. In inquiry-based learning, students make quite a fair bit of decision. Third benefit in inquiry-based learning is that students are given a lot of opportunities to learn, what some people might term as OTL, opportunities to learn. In such lesson, very often students are doing most of the work under the supervision or direction of a teacher. I think those are the three most important benefits to students during inquiry-based learning. Those are the three most important benefits, in my opinion, of inquiry-based learning. Opportunities to collaborate, opportunities to be independent, and having a lot of opportunities to learn because they are doing most of the work throughout the lesson, as opposed to listening to a teacher's explanation.
Well, understanding the concepts is more important because it makes you more flexible when doing math problems, especially math problems that you don't often find, such as high-order thinking problems, may require you to analyze and evaluate information more that based on your understanding of the math concepts more than just memorizing the existing formula to solve it. Also, by understanding the math concepts can help you in your real-life problems where they might not necessarily use the existing formula that you often memorize to solve them.
Students tend to develop a deeper understanding of whatever they are learning through inquiry-based learning because of the process described by Vygotsky, the interaction with your friends, the to and froing of arguing ideas that will allow them to make sense of the content a lot better and at a deeper level. I suspect Piaget's theory also alludes to that process that he referred to as accommodation. During inquiry-based learning, students often have opportunities, time to process information, and finally accommodating that information, which is what we call the knowledge structure of the students. So I believe that in inquiry-based learning, because of the social process described by Vygotsky and time provided for information processing described by Piaget, I believe that they will have a deeper understanding of whatever they are learning during inquiry-based learning.